public posts of us playing a game and letting him know that I am playing the game that he's been
so that
bugging me to play.
Shut up, yes.
Yes. To be fair, I don't blame him. I told him like a couple months ago that I'd let him borrow this.
This is true. And he has been...
Because it's a good game.
Chomping at the bit since.
I got you some cheese puffs, by the way.
Oh, you know me too well.
Yep. You don't care about pumpkins, do you?
Take whatever you want.
Do you eat pumpkin?
I don't know what you're saying.
Pumpkin.
Pumpkin?
Yes.
With a second P?
Yes.
Yeah, I'll eat whatever. Okay. Which one would you like?
Hey, whichever one you're not going to eat.
Boy, I'm going to hit you. Take the one that you want.
I am not that kind of person. I'm not going to invite someone to my house, offer them snacks, and then say, oh, but you get this one because I want to eat this one. I'm not that kind of person. You may be that kind of person.
Goddamn right.
Yep. All right. Yeah, we'll start here.
I'm too young to die. Isn't that the easiest setting?
Did I put it all the way down there? Like I said, I started on hard mode. I got really discouraged.
So you put it on super easy?
Is it super easy?
I'm too young to die? I'm pretty
sure.
Dude,
I put it... It probably is the easiest. I can't tell because I put it on that...
There's a lift.
When I finished that room with the multiple waves of enemies, and I am now in a platforming segment.
Cool. You know you can change the difficulty in-game, right?
But I'm not going to get any trophies for the hard or normal mode if I've switched it to easy at any point.
Okay.
Oh, you don't care about that, though.
It's a video game. I know that I beat it.
Here. So I don't get judged by myself or any, you know.
Okay. Top.
Hurt me plenty.
That'll work.
We'll go with some light BDSM. Yeah, that's a start. By the way, what did you think of Shin Godzilla?
It's interesting.
Yeah. Did you read my review?
I was there when we talked about your review.
You were? Physically?
In the car?
In the well, no, but I didn't write it yet.
Right. I was there watching you process your rough draft in your head.
Yes.
Yeah. I hate this guy. Yeah, I don't know. It's good shit. It's... I feel like because it wasn't a Godzilla versus thing, it was just a Godzilla movie, there was less Godzilla than...
Yes, except for the fact that despite a bigger budget, despite a smaller budget and being a single monster flick, it had more Godzilla to eat up and digest.
Sure.
Than
sure
the American.
Call that a smaller budget. I think that might be one of the largest budget Godzilla movies.
Well, in comparison to the American Godzilla movie from 2 years ago.
True.
That's what I'm comparing it to. Because
right.
Dylan and I were talking about it just this morning, and
it's amazing what the Japanese can do with $10 million that the Americans can't do for $100 million.
Agreed. We were commenting how the American one fell under a more traditional Godzilla movie formula. Wow, okay. It's things like that that make it why I haven't finished this yet. Before I get too far into this, I'm going to forward this over to...
Tyler.
Yeah, so that he can harass me while we watch. While he watches me be terrible.
Good.
Oh, wait, but he's probably with his lady at this point in time.
If he's smart, he'll watch this instead.
If he's smart, he'll watch this instead. Correct.
I just realized how poor of a design that Master Sword is.
Which one? On the poster?
Yeah.
Why do you say that?
Because it's thinner towards the handle, but thicker towards the end of the blade. That means that thing would break clean in half.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. That's a good point. Oh, perhaps it is appearing in the feed on here.
Here, if you would like to doodle with the
text. Doodle with the daddles. There we go.
We do the cool thing?
Which cool thing?
So you're gonna buy into this whole VR nonsense?
No, I'm not actually. I'm interested in it from a mechanical standpoint, but I have no interest in spending anywhere between $400 and $500 on it.
Do you not have the
what?
Upgrades?
Which upgrades? Sure I do.
Yeah.
Oh, because you were playing this on the PC.
Yeah.
Don't waste my gasoline!
Really trying not to. I'm also trying to figure out which one's the instinct go.
That would be R3. Yep, there you go. You know, out of all the monsters I've encountered, all the demons I've encountered in this game yet...
Yours is the most human.
I was just gonna say, I don't like this one. I like this one the least.
Why?
The one with the shield.
Okay.
I just don't like it. I'd rather fight this thing.
Okay.
Were you low on ammo?
I am now. Fresh out of chainsaw.
Well, you're gonna have to find some guzzoline for me then.
How do you change the weapon?
R1.
Ah, got it.
Yeah. Were you playing this with just mouse and keyboard then? Yeah, probably pretty smart. That being said, I'm pretty satisfied with the performance of this game on console.
It sure does run it. Probably 30 minutes.
But it's consistent.
Okay, well, that was my high school record.
Yeah.
That's a joke.
Yes, I get the joke. I'm not disagreeing with you. It's obviously going to perform better, but at least it doesn't perform terribly on console.
Okay.
I'm saying that this is probably the... Who's watching? Somebody's watching?
Us?
Who's
probably
watching?
Tyler?
No. Oh yeah, it probably is Tyler.
What up, nope. Nerd?
Open live chat. There we go. Tyler, I've been playing Doom this whole time.
No, he hasn't. I have no idea.
You nerds look gay. Miles, he calls gay. That is an insensitive comment.
Well, you're not. You're half right.
Shut up.
So that means he's not with his woman. He was lying to me, and he should be here.
Well, no, I sent it to him via text, so he's probably watching it on his phone.
He thinks the boy doth lie too much.
Mm-hmm. And he certainly does. I didn't catch. What's the challenge here?
I need to kill 10 of these things without killing myself. Also, I can only use barrels.
Oh, you can't hit them with the bullet. You have to kill them with the barrels?
Correct.
turns out Tyler is actually with the woman. He is just, on his phone.
Ah, what a pity.
Yeah.
Ditch the zero and get with the hero, nerd.
Well, at least he can sort of be with us while also doing the other thing.
This is true. Hi, woman.
He probably has headphones in.
Good. Hi, woman.
Oh, you're talking about him.
Him from me.
See, Tyler, Miles believes that he's a better lover than any other person you would ever have.
Goddamn right. Come on, baby, you know it.
Uh-oh.
I got whacked.
Here, shall I try? Tyler, refresh your browser, because our stream quality is fine.
Beat the nerd.
What's that line from Wayne's World?
One.
The one about the Pizza Hut sponsorship.
Oh. It's been a minute.
Yeah. It's been enough of a minute.
Basically, you just gotta kinda...
Yeah, you gotta get them clustered together a little bit.
Dance around hiding.
Yeah. But anyway... Back on the topic of the Godzilla thing, Dylan and I were commenting on how somehow the Japanese film, obviously in part by Anno, but it's produced by Toho in general, so it's just surprising that it was, of the two in the last couple years, it was the Toho one that was the least formulaic, and it was actually kind of revitalizing the franchise in a way. Right? No, you would disagree?
Well, no, it's just, it... Out of all of the Godzilla movies, it was the least Godzilla movie I've ever seen.
But in a positive way. Wouldn't you say? I mean, I commend it for trying something completely different.
Yeah.
But careful, there's one behind you.
It's... different.
Shoot.
I will say that. I mean, it's unique in that it's the only Godzilla I think I've ever seen that the Godzilla itself, the monster, was almost completely immaterial to the story. That was not so... I guess I ran out of time.
No.
It was not so much a Godzilla movie as it was a walking Fukushima... reactor movie.
Okay, but we discussed on the car ride home from the movie that that was essentially the original film as well.
True. But the... God damn it.
What are these, one-hit kills?
Well, yes, you have one HP.
Yeah, that would do it.
I thought it was far enough away. I don't know. It was a good movie. Don't get me wrong. I am in no way criticizing the film or the filmmaking. It's just, it was different.
Right.
Fuck.
Yeah, you gotta be mindful of that. I personally, it took me a bit to get used to the structure, and there was a point where I turned to Dylan and was like, oh wait, this is the whole movie, isn't it? Because I went in with not knowing what the structure was going to be at all. And but once I accepted that and got into the groove, I actually found myself enjoying that aspect of it.
Damn it. This thing don't explode very far. Well, yeah, it was a Japanese bureaucracy thriller.
Yeah.
The ticking clock element that just happened to have Shaggy Dog Godzilla in it.
Yeah, what'd you think of that, the evolving concept? Didn't quite sell enough for you?
No, it was neat. I didn't hate it. It was just kind of goofy.
Well, yeah, it was goofy, but I thought it was also interesting looking at it from the aspect of, yeah, he was googly-eyed, but it was almost like he was in amoebic form.
I suppose. He also looked like some sort of,
Muppet.
Kinda, yeah.
A little bit like a Muppet.
I do love the...
But isn't it funny that the more Muppety-looking version of him in the movie is the CGI one?
Yeah. Well, I gotta do. I do love the fact that they revealed it exactly like an angel.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Well,
I mean, he was going to do that no matter how they started the movie.
I suppose.
I mean, just because of the person who's behind it.
True, but Anno, he's, from what I understand anyway, he has always kind of tried to make a honest effort to get away from Evangelion. Like,
well,
he hasn't wanted that to be his...
His
what he's known as. Because that was kind of a depressing time in his life.
Yes, but it's also to thank for his success in life.
Well, he was... I'm not entirely sure how true that is. Because
no.
He... The dude spent a good deal of his time on other stuff. Like,
this is true. He did work on what was the film he worked on with Miyazaki? It was before Evangelion. It was one of the earlier Ghibli films.
Yeah. I don't know.
I could solve that by looking it up.
Yeah, dude's done a lot of stuff, but
developing Samsung TVs will integrate Steam Link's PC game streaming technology. Did you say about this?
This to me. Staggers to the edge.
So basically, this is a Chromecast designed for your gaming PC.
Could be interesting.
Well, I mean, you already kind of do that in your own house, but
yeah.
It's going to do that a lot more efficiently.
Yeah.
And it's going to be $50.
Television?
No, the broadcasts.
Oh, the Steam Link is already a thing.
Wait. So what's the $50? Is this the one?
If I had to guess, I'd say
the cost of the HDMI cable, maybe?
It's a specific cable, I think. It seems more like Samsung is going to be including the Steam Link in... Did I just make a full circle?
Yeah, that happens in this game.
It sounds to me more like the Steam Link is going to be built into Samsung phones. I could be wrong in this reading.
Nah, I gotta look back at this real quick.
So Do I want to keep going?
Balance. Yes. It'll give you a waypoint. There. Keep going that way. I think you're going up. Careful. So
is it up?
What, your waypoint?
Yeah, there you go.
Anything that's green.
That's less specific.
Valve and Samsung announced during Steam Dev Days this week that the future Samsung TVs will include Steam-like hardware inside.
Yeah, so it's built in.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, that's cool.
Not bad.
I wonder if they're going to fix any of the input lag.
Oh, you mean for the Steam Link transfer?
Well, it adds a certain amount of input lag into the system itself. So, like, when you're using the Steam Link, it adds an additional... Not a whole hell of a lot, but it's... I think it's like an extra 20 milliseconds of lag on top of whatever your setup already is.
Right.
And that's all dependent on your internet. So, I wonder if that is going to be... I wonder if that is going to be a part of this as well. Yeah. Oh. Okay.
Go on, Jafal. Here, let me see.
No matter what you do, I'm sure there's going to be some kind of delay just because of the nature of the beast.
Right. Yeah. Ooh, that texture loading. Okay.
This isn't unreal. I think this is, in tech.
Is that, what Wolfenstein ran on?
That's a good question.
Oh, no, that's shit, I came in that way.
Who did Rage again?
It.
It did that before they were bought by Bethesda, I assume. Oops!
Wait, what? How did you die?
I didn't grab the ledge.
But I thought there was no fall damage in this.
Sure there is.
Is there?
Yeah, after a certain point.
Never kicked in for me.
It's because you land in the right spot.
I have a tendency of doing that. Let's see.
Alright. I gotta figure out where I'm going. Want to get up there.
In tech.
In tech.
And this one? What?
In tech. How do I get higher?
Oh. Okay. Official Doom source port.
Do it again.
I want to wait for it to come as it's going down. You don't want to jump on it.
Mm-hmm. That you were right, sir.
It happens. Wow. Doom was 1993.
Yeah.
I'm old. Hey!
What?
Games that use the id engine Chex Quest and Chex Quest 2... Flemoids take Chextropolis.
I don't understand.
You never played Chex Quest?
I can't say that I have, no.
Man, you're
like,
missing out.
Like the cereal?
Yeah. Back in the 90s, I was part of a very popular TV show.
You were?
No, that's the ending theme from BoJack Horseman. Back in the 90s, I was part of a very popular TV show. No, but back in the 90s, Chex Cereal released an ad campaign for the little ledge up there. You want to double jump?
Yeah.
For Chex Cereal, I suppose.
Whoa!
How
okay.
Did you fuck that up?
I got caught in the carriage.
That's bizarre.
Yeah. I broke the game.
And one of them was Chex Quest, which was a Doom clone, if you will, about a piece of Chex cereal defeating all of the evil phlegm monsters called Phlemoids.
Phlegm monsters?
Called Phlemoids.
Why?
What do you mean, why?
Why were they phlegm monsters?
Because they were made of, like, sentient mold or something. It's cereal's worst enemy. Get it?
Oh. That seems a little
contrived.
Yeah, and also kind of like, what kids are gonna care about a plot about mold?
I did. It was great.
Oh,
it was also free.
Yeah, well, there you go. Free's good.
Back in the 90s,
ooh, do I want micro missiles? No. Improved venting.
The horse, BoJack. BoJack the horse.
Yeah.
Have you seen BoJack?
We talked about this last time I saw you. I've seen the first two episodes.
Oh, you gotta watch it. It's good. You gotta give everything a, the four-episode test, is what I call it.
I thought it was three.
Was it three? I don't know, it was four.
That means you have a tendency to give things benefits. It's worth that extra hour to you to give something a shot, which is commendable.
Well, 9 times out of 10, if there's something I'm getting into, it's because something's been recommended to me.
Yeah.
So, I don't, much to my own chagrin, I don't really go about exploring new things to watch as much as I do. Oh, I know what you need to do. Let me see the thing.
What?
Turn around and use it as a platform.
To get
to the, yeah.
There we go. We got it.
But yeah, so I watched a lot of stuff on recommendation from whatever people, friends, enemies, you name it. And so BoJack Horseman was one of them. I heard it on a podcast. I'm like, yeah, I'll check it out. And at first I'm like, oh, this is kind of kitsch. And then I realized that it is one of the most aggressively depressing shows I have seen
in a
very long time. You made it 2 episodes in! Like,
I was busy.
Yeah, okay. You've got to watch it. It's almost like, I want to say it's a go back.
Here?
Yeah. Look up.
There we go!
Level design. I don't want to say it's like a statement on mental health, but it definitely makes you think. Because, like, damn, man.
You cannot stop me from claiming what I am owed! What I was promised!
I don't care!
And there's a lot of very interesting parts to it. I don't know where that went.
The hologram?
Yeah, it said press whatever your squish button there.
Squish button, yeah.
I don't know. The thing that replaced the select button, because Sony's...
Oh, options? Monster.
No. Well, yeah, the other one.
No. Share? That's not the button.
I have no idea.
It's the squish button.
Yeah. So go over to your weapons.
Okay.
I don't see it.
Neither do I.
Yeah, it said hologram?
I guess. Go over. One of them has an exclamation point.
It's database.
Weapons, I'd assume. Hologram.
Great! What do I do with it?
Holocaster discharges an invisible cloud of ionized argon. Which camera then used to project an image through. I have no idea. We're never gonna need it.
Probably not.
I think it might be a grenade option.
I was gonna say, I barely ever even use the grenades.
Yeah, it is. See?
It is the grenades?
Oh. You gotta switch to the other one. It's like, I don't know what it is on yours. It's like Q on the keyboard, but I think it's like the D-pad, maybe? Yeah, hologram. There you go.
Ah!
Actually, I got one for it to reload.
Hello, Doom Man! Very good, now we know what it does.
Also, play more 999.
Yes! I do want to play that. Work!
That's unfortunate. Play video game.
I can't. I literally don't have the time. I don't have a fucking spare second. I am actively a salesman in a busy sales floor.
Yeah, stop doing that. Come work for Verizon.
Okay. Do I get paid more?
Probably.
I would. Actually, maybe.
How much are you getting paid now?
I'm not divulging that.
Because of stream or because of me?
Because of stream.
Nobody watching.
Yeah, but it's gonna get recorded. Oh my god, crazy melting woman. Okay. To let you borrow the last couple Kenshin movies. Or the last Kenshin movie.
Okay.
Yeah.
Again, there are places to find it.
Yeah, you could. But you could also watch it in pretty Blu-ray.
Sure. Funimation is releasing a...
Yeah, but the translation isn't that great.
Compared to...
The UK translation.
Ah.
Which is the ones that we have. Good job.
Have you... What? Do you know for a fact that it's a different
translation? Yes, because we have the steelbooks that we have are the UK import.
Okay.
And those are translated differently, and the Funimation translations are the ones that Dylan and I saw in the theater for all three movies.
Okay.
And there are certain phrasings and translations that kind of ruin it. For example, the ninja girl from Kyoto, Misao.
Uh-huh.
Everyone from Kyoto, but especially her, is written to have this really grating
accent,
southern accent.
Yeah.
Probably like they did in the cartoon.
No. That's a Japanese thing. Kyoto is considered to be like the south of Japan.
Okay, but they wrote it in a really obnoxious way.
Right. It's to... How do you perceive an accent?
Like, you're and yar and y'all and...
There you go.
But here's the thing. It's different hearing that enunciated than it is reading it.
Can you just make the distinction between a southern accent and a non-southern accent in Japanese?
Yes, I can't. Well, no, I can't.
Exactly.
I understand that they're writing it to make it understood that they're from a different region. Yes. But you could also just assume that the viewer is smart enough to understand that Kyoto is a different region and therefore slightly different culturally.
Did you know that?
Only because that it's been talked about
exactly
before.
But so yes. How else do you get it through to somebody who... Imagine you're from Japan and you come here, right?
Yeah.
Would you be able to distinct different accents just by, like, listening to us?
Yeah.
If you didn't speak a lick of English, you'd think that they're just saying different things.
Well, okay. Yes, I
because
understand.
If you don't understand the difference between you all and y'all, you just figure it's a different word. Also, gasoline. I don't know. I mean, it.
No, you are correct.
Right.
Yes.
I would much prefer that they don't, like, an editor's note of when the character starts talking. Well, because again, does her accent come up at any point during the movie?
In terms of exposition?
Yes.
No.
Is there a point where they go, oh...
There's a conversation about how people from Kyoto are different.
Well, there you go.
But that's it.
Understanding her difference is, in a very small way, admittedly, still plot relevant.
Sure. I get that.
Right, it's a translation choice. They want to be as... I'm not sure how it's
authentic. Why can't I pick up these shields?
Because you're full.
No, I'm not.
That's bullets for your machine.
Oh, why were they... There's shields.
Well, they're yellow, but whatever.
There's my shields.
Yeah.
Boom!
Bojack the Horse. Bojack. So I am in a bit of a moral quandary.
For yourself?
Yes.
Why?
I can either have the difference between $2,000 television, which will allow me to have a $2,000 television.
Yes, that would be very nice.
That would be very nice. The problem is that I don't really use my television when it's just me, but whenever I have company, it's kind of the focal point of the house, which makes it a very nice idea, also television. That door requires a yellow key, as I'm sure you have just realized.
Yes.
Because this continues to be doom. The other option I have is don't buy the $2,000 television, which I immediately do not like that plan, but save up for revitalizing my computer.
Well, so that comes down to how much money you would actually like to spend on something that is not only for yourself.
Well, a nice TV would be nice.
But again,
are you reaching for the controller?
What? No, keep on going.
Alright.
I just thought you were gonna check the thing.
Why do you keep shit moving?
I don't know. I just thought. if there was. Well, okay.
So you'd be spending the same amount of money, roughly $2,000, that is, upgrading your
computer,
PC,
to a brand spanking new thing. But the major difference is that I would get
this would be good.
Whatever that is.
I like it. Yes, please!
Yeah, this is the one that shoots through walls.
Oh, good. This is exactly
the railgun, never mind. Right, so the major difference is that, use the damn gas cannon.
I'm saving it for the big ones.
How do you know what it does?
I don't, but it's big, and therefore it's probably powerful, because Doom.
Right, you can replenish all of your ammunition with a chainsaw to a large thing.
I'm being careful.
Okay.
Anyway.
So I would be getting effectively a television for the house, which would be nice, because again, whenever you boyos come over, it would give us something to stare at.
Correct.
Along with my absolutely disgustingly nice stereo system. So my house would kind of then default be movie house, which I am perfectly okay with.
Right.
The other option is that I could get a fucking beast PC again, which, again, the computer that I have now is by no means antiquated, it's just starting to show its age.
Right, and when was it built?
2010.
Yeah. That sounds about right.
So, it is definitely in need of a bit of an overhaul. I would effectively just be building a new one from scratch at that point.
So what do you have in that computer now?
What do you mean?
In terms of the components.
Tech core, Intel processor, I've got a...
But what's the cores on it?
It's nothing special. It was like a prototype core, or a prototype CPU from way back in the day.
Okay.
So I think it's 2.5 gigahertz.
Oh, wait. That's
not really. It's kind of slow compared to the modern shit when it's 4.0 is
Okay, well, look, it's equal to an entry level all-in-one desktop that you would not be able to upgrade.
True. The thing is that it's got, because it was top of the line back when it came out, it's got all kinds of bells and whistles that the modern-day low-end CPUs don't have, optimized hyper-threading, long story short, my CPU could use some work, admittedly, but, I don't know, if I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna do it right, so I might as well just go all out with the damn thing. New graphics card, new CPU, new motherboard.
Understand.
I might as well get a new case at this point. Good old fashioned overhaul.
Shit.
Because it's my baby, you know?
Right. Where's that motherfucker?
Let's see, now would be a good time for a chainsaw.
What?
A fucking chainsaw. What?
There he goes. Bye bye.
So yeah, I don't know. It is enough to give me thought.
The desire to upgrade the computer alternatively to the TV.
Well, yeah, because I mean...
Because you could for that it depends on how much you want the bulb to be future-proof. You could spend the same amount of money on with the two together if you catch yourself with a good deal. Like, if you're very deliberate in the components that you shop for...
Considering I have
on the PC, then
no idea how budgeting or any of that fun stuff works, there's a distinct chance that I'm not going to be...
I'm going to take a look around here. That's just the key, isn't it?
There's a distinct chance that I am not saving for this. So... mean I would need to get a bulk lump of cash all at once. It's
or
probably
paper.
Going to have to... Yeah, it's not likely. Which
sure.
means I would probably have to wait until... What was that thing to your left?
Over here?
Or left? That thing.
Ammo?
Oh. Yeah, it would pretty much require me to wait for taxes.
What, the no tax day?
No,
or
tax
returns?
Tax.
Yeah, that's like half a year from now.
What are you talking about? That's January.
Oh, that's right. I forgot when taxes are due in the spring.
April, yes, if you put them off forever, but you can do them as early as January 12th.
Right.
Which I do, because why in God's name would I want to wait 4 months to get basically $3,000?
Right.
Which is then going to go immediately towards television.
Yeah.
Because I'm a gigantic child.
Well, so are all adults.
Gigantic child.
Blue key!
The major difference being is that most adults have, you know, means to an end. Me, I just want the damn thing.
Yeah. Don't really blame you.
It's a nice TV that you have on multiple occasions told me not to get.
I'm not telling you not to get it. I'm just telling you I can't buy it for you.
Well, there's also that, which we can discuss.
Hmm.
And again, not saying for me.
Fuck you! Come on!
I'm saying that you could creatively help me finance it.
Got it.
With your employee discount.
Let's not go there.
You started it.
Today? Yeah. What's this door? God damn. See, this is what happens. I beat a wave of enemies, feel real good about it, and then I kind of get lost.
So does Best Buy really have a snitch program?
Yeah.
Huh. That seems concerning. Have an official name, or is it literally just the snitch program?
I didn't say it was called that. I actually don't know what it's called.
Oh, damn it.
Does this... In the first battle, when the shadows...
Oh, geez, it's Dr. Claw.
One stood burned.
It's
by
just
the
generic evil voice.
Armageddon. His soul blistered by the fires of hell and tainted beyond a century, he chose the path of perpetual torment.
Really?
Turn off his audio?
I went past a checkpoint, so it automatically turned off the dialogue.
It's a pity, because that's explaining your backstory there.
And I can't really go backwards. Yeah, well. Give way! Somehow, the glory kills just, even though they obviously repeat, they don't feel old.
Well, they're context sensitive.
Yes.
The glory kills determine based on where you're looking when you enact them.
Oh, wait, I have the big gun. Makes that a whole lot easier. Oh boy. There we go. Ooh, that lag. Okay, alright. It's performing great up until just there. Oh, gospel bliss.
That's right, that's what I need to do.
Go to church?
Funny. Now, I... need to get a HDMI splitter.
For?
My television.
But what are you splitting?
One HDMI output into two. So my plan is, because I'm a clever bastard, the television that I'm looking at has five HDMI ports. Okay. Now, one of them is specifically designed for non-HDR, but very low input latency, meaning that it's good for gaming, but not HDR gaming. The rest of them are designed to work with HDR, but have a rather high amount of input latency. What I've figured out is that because everything is run through my receiver, I'm going to pump the output from my receiver, split it into two, and then select between HDMI 1, when I want to use the... the game in low latency, I'll switch it to the first HDMI port, and when I want to use HDR gaming, or otherwise look at pretty shit, I will switch it to HDMI 2. It's still the same output, but now it's split between two different input latencies. And yes, I am that anal.
Yeah, I don't blame you.
The difference between 11 millisecond lag and 56 millisecond lag is more than you'd think.
Yeah, so it would...
You've made a loop.
It did. I didn't do none. Am I back at the start again?
Yes.
Telling
you to go to the right. That door there, apparently.
Nah, because if it was... It's behind the door.
Behind the door. So... Okay, hit start. Other start. Find the portal back. Okay. So it looks like, see where the marker is? If you look, it would appear as though there's a way to go around it. See? That door is where you... Okay. See where your little yellow arrow is?
I do.
So that means that in between there and that goalpost, there's a door. But if you see north of that, it wraps around to where you just were. So if you hop over that, you should be able to get behind that door.
Got it.
But now I need to research and find a HDMI splitter that works with HDMI 2.
There's a doll up there.
What?
One of the little Doom Guy dolls.
Ah. Yeah, so then I'd say if that's all locked off, then the only way to get through would be that door. So you gotta figure out a way to open the door. My guess is, as everything else in this game, it'd be through murder. Not murdering the door, Evan. I do believe it is murdering people.
You mean demons?
Sure. Look, there's
or I could just keep
up.
Going up.
Yeah.
What's that?
That's a challenge marker.
I knew that.
Do that if I were you.
No, it's a shield. That's what I thought.
Secret found.
Secret shield?
I said secret found.
Eh, that works.
Deep. But yeah. So, I gotta look into getting myself an HDMI splitter.
Yeah, we got those.
Alright, well, an HDMI 2 splitter. I need to stock up. There we go. I need to stock up on 3 HDMI 2 compliant cables. Make sure that everything is running tiggity boo.
Tiggity boogity.
Although I believe the cable itself doesn't matter so much as the input. So research just in case. Where's the door goes? Ah, here we are. Active 4K HDMI splitter. That'll do, Pig.
All day. Yeah, that's the other thing, is that you do need 4K pass-through component cables, so you'd have to change. And you would need a 4K pass-through receiver.
Already have that.
So there you go, you already got that. So as long as you get new HDMI cables for everything, then everything will get upscaled to 4K as best it can.
So that's the thing, is that the cables are made uniformly. I don't really think that there's a difference between...
No, there is stronger bit strength on the HDMI cables, the ones that are 4K ready.
Okay, let's find out.
Unless they've just all been improved in general.
I think it's more of a sales gimmick. Let's find out.
It probably could be.
Ah, good. Like, here we
most
are.
Most likely correct.
4K HDMI cables are nonsense.
There you go. That's awesome. I'm glad they are.
The slow and inevitable transition to Ultra 4K happening, whether it's necessary or not. Surprising that cable manufacturers are jumping at the chance to sell new and more expensive 4K HDMI cables. But guess what? You don't need 4K HDMI cables, because the current HDMI cable ones use 4K just fine. Seriously. Here's why. In case you missed the terminology on HDMI cables, check out why all HDMI cables are the same. Why all HDMI cables are the same part 2, still more reasons why all HDMI cables are the same, and the HDMI cable buying guide. That's still the best.
Yup.
Here's the short version. There are only 4 kinds of HDMI cables. High speed with internet, high speed without ethernet, standard speed with ethernet, standard speed without ethernet. There's no reason to get standard speed cables anymore, as the price difference is negligible between those and the high speed version. The current HDMI 1.4 spec. In order for an HDMI cable to be considered high speed, it must be able to pass practically 4K speed at up to 30 frames per second. Even the cheapest high-speed HDMI cable can pass the maximum resolution possible with the current generation of Ultra HD 4K TV.
There you go.
Yep.
So, it's just a bunch of garbage.
They're
charging an extra $40 for HDMI cables for no reason.
What a shock. What do you mean, for no reason? There's a quite definitive reason.
Oh, money.
There you go.
Which, for, you know, everyone but a few people is no reason.
Exactly. Although, what's
oh, hello. Here?
I did not realize that, HDMI could transfer Ethernet.
Oh, is that right?
Apparently.
That's, What a lie.
HDMI 2.0? Hey.
Back to Mars. Okay.
Get your ass to Mars.
We got to get back to Mars.
The cable is just a dumb pipe. It doesn't care if the data flowing through it is 4K video, high def video, standard def video, or anything in between. Yeah. Oh, fuck that noise. 2005.
2005 what?
There's a new variant of an HDMI that came out, and here I am thinking it's all recent. Came out. Or 2015, rather. It came out last year. October of 2005. 2015. Fuck.
2015.
Yes.
Got it.
Yeah, go figure.
Where's my porto to Mars? Oh, I see. Behind the blue door. Okay. Alright, I got to get down.
Get down! Get down again!
There it is. Oh my god.
Hey!
Go away! You ugly bitch!
What do they use all those things? Boomers.
I don't know, what are they called? Oh.
Floaters.
Long cock demon. Caca demon. As in, it is shit demon.
Behind you.
Thank you.
It was Josh Yerman beat you to death with it.
I know it did. That's doom for you.
How clever of it.
I know, you would think it just, you know, would wave my arm in the air and not give a shit.
This is true. So, how good are those Best Buy product service guarantees or those things there?
Their replacement plans?
Yeah.
Well, actually, it depends on the product. Because different products have different plans. So if you get, like, a camera, it's an accidental plan that covers drops and cracks and waters and stuff like that.
Okay.
And then, obviously, similar with computers, but obviously the screens are more expensive to replace. So basically the plan is that it covers the it covers repair and shipping costs and labor costs up equal to the value of the computer and the protection plan combined. So if it's a bunch of small fixes, you're fine, but once it exceeds the cost of the computer itself, it's not worth them worth the time for them to do anything with it. If that makes sense.
Yes. So, not worth it on television.
Probably not. It really it only would protect you from power surges.
Right. I'm looking more for an extended warranty more than...
Well, that's exactly what they're offering.
Okay.
It's an extended warranty on the TV.
Good.
Yeah, it depends on the cost of the components of the TV, too, so it's not universal.
Right. What do you think of it? Is it a 5-year plan to get anything? I'd grab the purple orb if I were you.
Holding out until the big stuff comes up.
Chains on the damn thing.
On purpose, of course.
What?
On purpose.
Did it have the chains on?
Yeah, so I use it when I need it. Oh shit!
You wanna do this?
Sure.
Go for it. Ooh. Ripped out vague organs.
Vague organs. Probably your intestines.
It seemed,
Pick down and eat your appendix.
But go ahead, sell me on a television.
Well, you already know exactly what TV that you want.
Yep.
I'm not going to stop you from getting the TV that you want.
Disgusting amount of research.
Yeah, in fact, you knew more about the two different types of HDR than anybody that I work with, so... Yep. To be fair, there's a shit ton of stuff.
Hell of a persuasion tactic, Evan.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you want me to roleplay for you?
What? No,
I'm
kidding. Fuck God, dude.
Sales roleplays?
Never do that. Never. Literally the worst.
Absolute worst.
No, I was just trying to rationalize the damn thing.
I had some asshole who interrupted a sale I was doing on a Samsung TV. He was like, "Excuse me, but those guys, those Samsung guys, are putting cameras inside of their TVs and they're spying on you." And I said, "Sir, I'm not going to necessarily disagree with you, but I'm going to point out the fact that this gentleman you're warning here owns an iPhone, so he's already surrendered all this exact information that you're telling him Samsung is going to take."
There you go.
Yeah, I mean, did you actually say that to the customer?
I did. I'm not gonna bullshit, dude.
How do you switch the
mods?
Yeah,
there you go.
Always go with the grenade. Then you can do this.
Yeah. So I keep picking the wrong mods.
Yes.
It's okay. At least it doesn't... It's fucking up on the D-pad on this one. On the PC, it's the most annoying thing in the world. They set it to R, which is the universal reload button.
And like, but there's no reload button in this.
Exactly. So your brain thinks, fuck, I need to reload.
So you keep... And then you keep hot switching your modifications.
Exactly. After a while, your brain just kind of kicks in thinking, like, oh, shit. It's been a while since I manually reloaded. And I am definitively one of those
types. Well, didn't I tell you? It took me however many, the first couple missions to realize that I wasn't reloading playing this game. And then you revealed to me that it was mentioned in the Zero Punctuation review, and I said, of course it was.
But
the fact that there's no reload button.
Yes. I've mentioned the fact that it's been like that forever.
Yes.
It's been like that forever. There's never been a reloading animation in a Doom game. Possibly Doom 3?
Yeah, but that was the most un-Doom game.
Yeah, it was kind of a stretch.
Well, I mean, it was just a survival horror game.
I wouldn't say survival, but definitely a more combat-oriented game.
More combat-oriented?
Well, yes, it was...
You had a flashlight in this game.
Instead of a weapon, correct.
Wow! You did that mid-air! Shit's cool.
Is to blind it first.
Genius! You miss Metal Gear, don't you?
Pretty much constantly at this point.
I mean, to be fair, you had accepted Metal Gear Solid 4 as kind of an end to Metal Gear anyway.
This is the best one it'll ever get.
Best ending.
Yeah.
I mean, I understand that you and quite a few people like Peace Walker.
I like Peace Walker because of where I thought the series was going.
Yes, and then once you knew where it ended up, you don't feel like you need to play it again. Based on a gameplay element, well, Peace Walker's nice for a quick dose of Metal Gear.
Yes, because it was designed for that. It's a goddamn mobile game.
Right.
Which there's nothing wrong with. It's also built on the rather fantastic, somehow, Hunter Engine, the thing for all the Monster Hunter games.
Yes.
Which is fine, that's exactly what I want.
But the motivation of is... finishing it was based on the narrative, as every other Metal Gear game is.
Yeah.
And now that we know the outcome of that plot line...
Well, yeah, it still makes for a nice side story. It's unfortunate that the ending is garbage. But, Peace Walker kind of had... not distinctively, but it had a... Did I murder anything?
Music ends when you kill everything.
It had a... kind of self-sustaining story. I mean, it ends on... Yeah, which one that does? Not so much a cliffhanger as it does a open question of what comes next. Because Pacifica Ocean, or POS, is clearly not dead. Oh, I did win. But then there's also the question of, A, what the fuck was going... What just happened is basically the biggest one. The second part of all that is, who the hell was Kos talking to? Which everybody just kind of assumes is Zero, but it later revealed is that pretty much couldn't have helped, I take it?
At this point, you can upgrade any of the other two.
Helped it is.
May as well max it out.
Yeah. So, it's revealed later on, supposedly he's talking to Zero. But as it's later revealed, there's almost no way he could be talking to Zero. Or, well, no, because the Peace Walker still takes place before the time jump. So, it's possible he's talking to Zero. But then it makes no sense later on why he would be teaming up with... I don't know. Five just... It felt like Kojima had a lot less to do with it than Kojima would have liked.
Yeah, it didn't 100% feel like his game. Which is a shame because the gameplay was so good.
Yeah, it was. That's why I am tentatively interested to see what they do with Metal Gear Survive.
Or just with anything on the Fox Engine.
Well, they already have some stuff on the Fox Engine, and it's kind of trite, so what are you going to do?
You mean 5 and Ground Zero.
5, Ground Zero, and PES 2016.
Wait, why do I not know what that is?
Professional Evolution Soccer.
What?
Yep. They rewrote the thing.
That soccer game runs on Fox Engine?
Yes.
Why?
Why not? I mean,
what the shit?
Yeah, it's the fucking, Booga Booga Demons or whatever.
Ooga Boogas? The Oogie Boogies?
They needed to recoup the cost on how much fucking Kojima spent to make that damn thing. And considering that all of the other stuff that they were banking on, i.e. Silent Hills, was not going well, despite being fucking fantastic. Dude, Junji Ito.
How amazing would that game have been?
Pretty goddamn amazing. Junji Ito was set to do character design. Or enemy design. Which would have been like... Have you read Uzumaki?
I have not.
Read Uzumaki.
I like how it doesn't give you the codec on the demon until you've actually killed one.
Yeah. Sure. I don't know. I would be interested to see where Konami goes with Metal Gear. At the same time, they are trying their damnedest to get out of the whole video game market, period.
Yeah, what was the thing recently announced from Konami? It was something. I saw an ad.
The Silent Hill pachinko machine?
No, it was like a hardware product. Yeah.
I know that they're making a Metal Gear and Konami in a... They're making a Metal Gear and Silent Hill pachinko machine.
Yeah,
as well as a Castlevania sexy pachinko machine. What in God's name is that? Yay!
What is... Oh my God!
That's Commander Keen.
Wow.
That's awesome. I'm also curious to find what that is. I love the Commander Keen. That's awesome. You probably know what I'm talking about.
Vaguely.
One of its first projects. Look up Commander Keen.
Will do. Once I figure out what this... Konami Holdings Corporation.
Yeah, that's what they are now. There we go, full arsenal.
Full? Not full. No BFG yet.
Alright. So, Commander Keen.
Wait, is that the BFG?
No. Commander Keen. Chain gun.
Chain gun.
Let's see.
He's a terrible!
Yeah, and there he is. There's his battered dead skull. That's fun. Anyway,
and it's on Steam.
Forget what this does. Shit. Well, I will figure that out better for the next life. Shazbot. Oh, right.
Can you not,
Yeah. You need two hands to carry the big gun.
Ah. Man, what a pretty place hell is, huh?
It's got its moments.
I mean, I'd never actually go on vacation there.
Well, I'm pretty sure if you're going to hell, you don't have much in the way of a choice.
True.
I think this is where you go when you've been presumably bad or disagree with one or two major religions too long.
One or two. Or all.
Just the fun ones.
Now you're keeping an eye out for more Easter eggs.
Well, no, I saw it in the periphery of my vision, and I thought it was a script of some sort, and I suppose that was half correct. So let's see. I can't see how many two, I think.
Yeah, you got two.
Oh, well, there's that. Now you have one. Perfect.
Multiple DNA.
So now your radar gives off where the secrets are.
That would have been useful. There we go.
Good old skull shove activated door.
There's a lot of shove activating in this game.
And that's the best way to do anything.
I admire how few fucks Doomguy truly gives. Oh my God, it's going through him like butter.
The bullets?
Yes.
Yep. Hey, he's the Doom Guy. Doom Guy don't give a shit.
Doom Guy don't give a fuck and it's admirable.
I'm so glad that this game doesn't have to be shit.
Yeah, I know. It makes me wonder how Quake is actually going to end up being. Because Wolfenstein was good.
Evidently. Yeah, but it's not a single-player Quake. Wolfenstein was fantastic, as you'll soon find out. Right, Quake is an online arena.
Right, and the multiplayer for this is the least interesting. part of it.
Apparently it's enjoyable.
Well, here's the thing, is that it can all the multiplayer handles the same way that Doomguy feels in the campaign, right? So it doesn't, maybe it's just a gameplay style that doesn't lend itself to multiplayer.
Well, apparently it plays a lot like the original Halo.
Is that right?
Yeah, because it's like arena-based shooting. Like they did back in the day before they invented kill trees and overkill and all the other trope shit.
So it's just simple.
Back when games were good.
Slayer. Sailor. Slayer's a captain of the flag, basically.
Because Halo was largely based around Unreal Tournament.
Yeah.
Or, maybe not based, but modeled itself after, perhaps. Man, this game looked rough early on. Wow. That was a separate build. It was basically a different game entirely.
Oh, early on in development. I thought you meant like the first couple of missions. Like, no, it looked fucking great.
Beta build of the original
Of the original game?
Whatever this was supposed to
be. What this was? No.
Yeah, look up 2016 Doom beta or original footage or some shit like that. Because this game used to look like alarmingly different.
Well, the beta was what was what people played after Wolfenstein came out, right?
Correct. But there was also a beta build of the game. Like, not beta like what they let the kids
play.
So
we're not looking at the one from 6 months ago. We're looking at the one from like a year ago, maybe.
No, beta build, not like playable beta, like what this game would have been, previous iteration or whatever you want.
I understand that. I'm just making sure, because everything I'm looking up is from the multiplayer beta.
Okay, so you want to look up...
Probably pre-alpha.
Sure. Doom 2016 Alpha. I think we got it. See, that's why I look.
Yeah, from October 2015, probably, right?
Maybe. The one that looks ass ugly.
It's possible.
Or whatever. Look up Doom 2016 original trailer.
Search the original trailer.
Alright. Launch into a glory kill from much further... Oh, that's the one I want. Use the heavy assault rifle to weaken and deform death from a blow of glory kills on 3 Hell Knights.
Okay. I want it. Give it to me.
What?
I want that.
One more.
That.
So the name of the game is Tricky Dumbass. Getting hurt perfect down here. Going up here. And then fuck. Shit. Balls. Damn it.
So you have to kill them all from up on
above
the ledge.
Yeah, so I gotta jump off the ledge and then kill them from below.
So as in, you have to be in midair while they die.
Correct. Oh, fuck it. Come here, dumbass. So I want you to stay there and get hurt enough. That works.
Yeah. Okay, so we're looking at the Doom trailer from 2014.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah.
were standing on the edge.
No, it's a cinematic. Give me a thing. Give me a cinematic. Give me gameplay.
Build of this thing looks like fucking ass on fire.
Here, let me see if I can find it. And this game's been in development for a while. Doom.
I'm gonna search 2013 trailer.
2016.
Original. Doom 4 canceled version footage.
That's the one. Yep, that's the stuff.
What?
Yep. So that's what this was going to be.
Oh, no. Oh, God, it's a Gears clone.
Yep.
Oh, fuck that. I don't like that.
So the one I want is... Actually, I kind of want a combo of the two.
Was this before or after they got bought by Bethesda? It's only 30 seconds of.
Yeah, that's pretty much all they had. That's a good question.
Let's find out. Call of Doom, yeah. People call it Call of Doom.
That's about right.
Dodged a nuke by canning this trash, they say.
It didn't look great, that's for sure. Oh, that would appear to be a portal to hell. Yep.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
On par for the course for this one.
Tempered by the fires of hell, his iron will remain steadfast through the passage that preys upon the weak. For he alone was the Hellwalker, the unchanged predator who sought retribution in all quarters, dark and light, fire and ice, in the beginning and the end. And he hunted the slaves of doom with barbarous cruelty, for he passed through divide as none but demon had before.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
I just can't get enough of my dick.
Yeah.
Come on, baby, you know it. I love that little.
Okay. I love the one mission where you take. You find the dude who got slaughtered, just tear his arm off and just slap it on the sensor and just slides up. Nope.
Alright,
I'll be right back.
Oh, that's what I want.
What?
That's the one that I want.
Little drone thingy that you punch.
Remote detonator, that's cool, but nah. Doing a charge, high damage. Siege mode. Ah, okay. Use the beam button to charge up a more powerful beam that penetrates targets. Move it disabled before using the siege mode. Huh. Stun bomb. Gatling chain gun not firing. That's hold on to transform the weapon barrels into a mobile turret. I don't know what that means.
Triple minigun!
Yeah. Yeah, I just did that.
Gold of a minigun mine. Oh, thank God, you killed him.
Also, your increased range thing here is pretty bonkers.
The what?
So, remember that challenge that I thought was hard that turned out well?
Yes. What was the thing that you won out of that?
It gives you the range that you can hit the fucking enemies from when you do
all that is
rip and tear.
Yay.
Yes.
I'm assuming that's for a number of glory kills executed.
Probably. As long as they're stunned, it increases the range of effect that you have to fucking whack them with the thing. So as soon as this bitch will stop moving for a goddamn second.
So as in, the distance in which you can activate a glory kill is further.
Correct. And then later, when you power this thing up more and more, it becomes absolutely ludicrous.
So they could be like a whole room away and you can activate it. Wow!
Yeah, like that.
Goal!
And then the farther away you are, the more ridiculous it is, but you're basically like attack more on tightening across rooms.
It's like fucking Goku.
Not fair.
Oh, there he is. It's Tim Curry.
Man, how did you get that reference?
Because I've seen that movie. Twice.
Yeah, but like...
Also, Tim Curry is a master of cinema. Tim Curry is a master of cinema.
Yes, he is a master of cinema. You are correct. I can watch my failure and repeat. That's always fun.
Yeah.
Who else do we have?
Oh, oh, yeah, that's it. I mean, I could try to make other people watch it.
Yeah, that's all right.
It gets archived. I just like the low maintenance of streaming with the PlayStation camera.
What?
I like the low maintenance of streaming with PlayStation compared to the
iPad. Very Actually, you know what? Fuck it. Do my job.
What's gonna be good?
They're attacking each other.
Ah, that they are. Until he starts throwing shit at you.
Yeah.
There you go.
Now I have to punch him in the nip tendon, now we're good.
After a while, these guys just get a little obnoxious.
Yeah, the pinkies. Bop them in the grundle. There we go.
Ew, not the grundle.
Alright, let's figure out this purple thing.
Quadruple damage.
There we go.
Hopefully that other guy shows up before it runs up. There he is! Wow! I like it! The violence is pleasing!
Ladies and gentlemen, you heard it here first. Evan Griffin, confirmed sociopath.
I mean, they're demons. You can't show any kind of sympathy to demons.
That's your excuse.
What demons do you sympathize with?
Ones I've earned from drinking too much.
Ah. So, the bottled ones.
That's a joke.
That's a joke. Oh, look! Zelda enemies.
What?
So, Zelda enemies.
The bubbles?
Yes, the bubbles. Why are they called bubbles?
Japan.
Yeah. Oh, Japan. Wish it was faster, though.
What? The bubbles?
No, that. The launcher missiles.
Yeah,
I suppose.
Doggone.
Yeah, I can hear it.
Still not. There are some solid upgrades that I have not found yet. Chainsaw.
Oh,
Oh, okay. Got one half. Yeah, there are chainsaw upgrades.
There are. So I just hadn't found it.
Correct. Exploration items appear as the auto map automatically. And become completely immune to explosive barrels.
Yeah.
That's what we're saving for. Plasma rifle, I hate this fucking thing.
Yeah, it's not the best weapon on the docket, that's for sure.
Yeah. Well, that's why it's always the best idea to use all its ammo first, so you don't have to go back to it now.
Well, you know what I find is that those, the Hulk ones, what are they called? Did you get that gas?
Full up.
Okay. The Hulk ones that run in ground pound at you?
Yeah.
I find that the plasma rifle slows them down pretty
well.
Yeah,
it's got like a hit stun.
Yeah.
Pretty sure we're maxed out on just about everything.
Pretty much. Health max is 200. Shields are maxed.
Always important to search. Oh, I believe I'm going.
Are there any dolls to find? I'm assuming this mission is going to be done within like a couple minutes, I would imagine.
I think we're getting there. Memory serves, this is kind of a straight shot through hell that then gets fucked up.
gets fucked up?
No, your return from it.
Ah.
Again, if memory serves.
Hello, friends. It has its limits.
Yeah, but I just want to see what those are. Also,
exactly.
You power it up by doing... Whoops. There.
You power up by doing what?
Engaging. It's like a leveling system. The more of those takedown kills you do, the stronger and the longer range it becomes.
Oh, so it's not just upgraded from the challenges. Why are they killing each other?
Hell. So,
oh, right.
When you
hell.
Go to here...
Yeah.
Upgrade
oh,
to
these.
Level 2.
Yes.
And then, right, so I'm at 19 of 75.
I thought it was like, I thought you were implying like GTA style, the more you use it, the more it gets. I'm like, that can't be how it works.
Later. There's nothing to check it out. Biggity bounce eye titties, y'all.
Like those two. Yeah, just rocket launch them. Or that.
Yeah.
It's basically a railgun.
Yeah. Let's try that different. Fuck, now I get to watch my shame and repeat. Oh, goddamn. Actually, since it was at 19 last time, how am I at now? Ooh.
Which is, oh, you see that fog popping?
Yeah.
Ah, there you go. Were you trying to glory kill them and we're headshotting them instead? Yeah, the assault rifle will do that.
Exactly what happened. Is that what I can do?
So what happens to the souls that are killed in hell?
I assume they go to hell.
They go to more hell?
Yeah.
Mm.
Now, if my math is correct, I should be at 22.
What, on the glory kill?
Yes.
Yeah, it's possible.
And then I can grind it out. Also, I can't see through us, so I'm gonna have to guess when this thing's done.
Oh, it'll tell. You'll be
yeah,
able to see
I
the pee.
I can see just a little bit of it.
Yeah.
There we go. All right. Oh.
Oh, good job.
Duh.
Yes, because then you don't waste ammo.
And I don't murder them as good. Exactly. Right.
Just punch them and then re-punch them.
I could do that, couldn't I? Okay. 27. Alright. Bad luck. The life on the high. assuming you have given this thing any kind of upgrades. Nope.
Ooh, Skullcracker. I don't know.
Yeah, I should probably save up that for the minigun here.
Well, any other shotgun upgrades?
Probably. Instant load.
That's a good one.
Yeah,
if you find that you use it.
Some of those are pretty solid.
There you go.
Yeah, Tuffy's gonna...
Yeah, he's gonna decimate those guys.
Oh.
Wow. Okay. Okay. Well, they're gonna be a lot easier to kill for you. I keep forgetting about the scope mod on this. This is so much better.
Well, they both have their uses.
Yeah, considering you don't have to lock on with that, we don't have to aim with that one.
Nope.
There he goes.
Man, what are your challenges?
What a pretty sight.
Kill 10 demons while using power-ups. Perform leg sweep glory kills on hell-based.
Ah, that's probably sliding and glory kill. Jesus. This guy's miserable.
Bad position here.
There you go. Takes a while to reload. There you go. It's a shame that they never drop shields, but I guess there's no point.
My right leg, which would be this one, so I want to attack its left leg.
I think you're thinking about it too hard. You just shoot it.
Right. The challenge specifies that I need to sweep the leg, Johnny.
Ah. Is it only that monster? That's
what the challenge says.
Okay.
So, I can...
There you go, Tuffy. Particularly bad at finding the Doom Guy dolls. Little
yeah,
pop figures.
Well, they're supposed to be they're supposed to be hidden.
But they come up on the map. And I infrequently check the map.
Yes.
Wrapped in his conquest against the blackened souls of the doomed, his prowess was shown in his crusade. The Seraphim bestowed upon him terrible power and speed.
Angels,
and with his might, he crushed
angels,
the seven pillars of the blood temples. He set forth without pity. The beasts of the nine circles, unbreakable, incorruptible.
Boys can't do that stuff. Okay, another armor thing. 1. Potentially 7, definitely 1. Happening, and they give you a fuck ton of ammo and health. That's what's commonly referred to as a boss fight. So this thing is telling me to go down this way, which is curious. You still need to play 999.
Like a pretty tough challenge.
Yeah, it makes it a challenge. That is.
Doi!
Pardon the pun.
Yes.
Challenge.
It's not even really a pun, it's just what it is.
But pardon the dick.
Pardon the dick. Oh, look at him! Chubby's back.
Punch him as the asshole. Oh, right, I forgot about that.
Yeah, it works. Draws the fire away from me for a minute.
And he poured the storm.
Jesus. Baka, 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 baka. Any help. Anyone, anywhere.
So red.
Easy, it's blue.
They're fine, but I can't see it.
Fuck. The two?
Okay.
One tubby, one lanky. Yeah, and he gotcha. Yeah, close. Tyler, where are you?
Not here. Turn the voices again?
Possibly.
bastard.
Sitting in their den, I guess I can't really call them relentless. If you're in hell. What's to be expected in hell?
They were here first.
And technically, it was just Lucifer and friends.
But like Lucifer started it.
Have you read Paradise Lost?
Paradise Lost? Not as much as the title, but...
I'm just saying, like, that's what happened. That was the war. As they called it.
Right.
I don't know. Let's not talk about it. It was a hard time. Jesus. Holy shit!
Get lucky. So far, I've been
unlucky.
Lucky.
He just tore you in half, and then bitch slapped you. That's unfortunate.
How did you do?
I'd say you want me to try, but you're superior at this than me.
No. One more.
One more?
One more.
One more.
And either way, we're grinding out a shit ton of kills, so...
That's a good point. The ammo doesn't reset once you die, though. You gotta get it all back. Does it? I don't know. I'm gonna pay attention next time you die.
I know.
Pay attention or die.
Okay,
let's go. Yeah. Yeah, save that quad damage power up for that rush of evil. Bash your way up there. Do you have any chainsaw fuel? Not that.
Also, damn it. Still damn it.
Okay, alright. Get a little bit there.
Definitely not.
Okay, you got that.
They're doing enough damage to themselves, where it all kind of works out.
Yeah, if only you could just stand by like before and let them kill themselves.
Yeah.
Okay, there you go. Okay, alright. Trying to figure out what you can do with this guy. I guess it's kind of right now. Trying to figure if you should, after the first... What's the actual name of them?
Dan, HC Weekend is coming up. I don't know what that is.
That first boomer, whatever their actual name is. I'm trying to figure out if you should hold off on killing it and then get the quad power up, or after the wave of the two Tim Currys come in.
I'm going to assume murder as much as humanly possible.
Yes, but you gotta strategize it.
I can't, it's coming up as whatever. Okay.
See, I can do small child.
Who's the small child?
My sister.
Oh.
She wants me to come up to Boston to go see some play.
You don't like plays.
She needs her attention.
Yeah, socializing at Suffolk University is quite challenging.
don't know why.
Because it's a school of a bunch of people that are largely antisocial and don't really have a goal for themselves. Yeah. Unless they're in business and law.
I've found that out of all of the people I associate with, antisocial people with no goal in life are pretty much all of the people I associate with.
Maybe they just gravitate towards you, Miles.
What can I say?
Something about the directionless in life.
Hey man, I'm practically a standee of it. Still have not watched JoJo.
I've seen the first two seasons.
Okay, well you're missing the best two.
I get it, I just need to catch up.
Yeah. You have my Crunchyroll information, right? I don't know if that's working or not.
Your Crunchyroll?
On the Hellraiser, attack right leg. Yes, my Crunchyroll.
I thought I surrendered the access to it. Do I have it on here, I wonder?
One way to find out.
Yeah, we'll check when we're done. Maybe I had it on the PlayStation?
It's the PlayStation.
The other PlayStation.
What other PlayStation?
The PlayStation 3.
Is this where you predominantly consume your media?
Yes, but I've only had it for a year. Or a little over a year. The PS4.
Okay.
And you've had Crunchyroll for how long?
A while.
Yeah, like 5 years, right?
I realize that time seems to be getting more and more away from me.
Yeah, so it could be 5 years. I was still in school when you had Crunchyroll, and everybody, you were giving everybody your login. All right, get that power up now.
Now what am I gonna eat?
There you go. Another boomer. Is he here? Yeah, that's another chasing one. It's another boomer.
I think that's it. Oh, 5 left though. That's good.
Oh yeah. You got it.
Still the best. 2016. 2016.
2016. Gotta love Ghana. Ghana movie. Ghana movie 2016.
2016.
Gotta love those effects.
Hey man, can't knock them. Still better than anything I've ever made.
It's better than most of the movies that have come out in 2016.
Excuse me. 2016.
Now, 2016. I mean, really, almost all the movies in 2016 so far have been fucking garbage.
What?
How was Deepwater Horizon?
Predictable.
Yeah.
I mean, oh. That's my coffin.
That it is. Sarcophagi. Oh, go punch the thing.
Yeah, well, I want to see what he's doing with me.
He's being a Talos principal.
Have you played that?
I've watched a lot of gameplay of it. I like it. I have not yet played it.
Boy. I like that there's just, like, a stand here that says, oh yeah, just go to hell, or go back from hell, or whatever.
I know, right? It's like a little, like, okay, here's your portal, bye.
Okay, so the robot's in on it.
Well, yeah, because where else was he harvesting the Argent energy from other than hell? Of course he had ulterior motives.
That also means that you natively come from hell.
What, Doomguy?
No. Because you wake up in that coffin.
Well, you're clearly a human being that wakes up that, clearly a human being that has probably slaughtered many, many people and therefore ended up in
entire
hell.
chapter was backstory about the Doom guy.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
You are a...
prophetic.
Something blessed by an angel. Who has so much blood on his hands that he is capable of going where only demons do.
The Argent Tower is destroyed.
Tokens!
The portal can no longer be closed from this side. The hell energy flows from a location in their world we call the Well. But you've returned. The only flesh and blood to walk between dimensions. So there may be a way. Vega is trying to access Olivia's files. If you can get to the nearest terminal, we will provide you with information. That's all for now.
That's fair. So, don't trust him.
So are you getting the PS4
Pro? No.
No.
Why? I bought it.
Because it works better?
How much better?
Depends on the design, I guess.
Yeah, I'll hold up on that. I mean, come on. Like, when's the PS5 coming out?
Well, so that's kind of sparked this whole debate.
I think, obviously, people are talking about it because based on the logic of, oh, well, Xbox is already talking about this thing dubbed Scorpio,
right,
and Nintendo will have the NX out in the spring. So it could end up being a repeat of this generation where Nintendo puts out the thing the earliest and therefore it's a little outdated as a result. And then one console gets announced prematurely, and then another gets announced as a reaction.
I think... oops, little floaters. I think what's more likely happening this time around, from what I can tell... it seems more like to me what's happening is... the NX was really, really banking on being the strongest hardware of this generation, which is entirely possible. It still might be. I mean, fucking who knows.
Yeah, there you go. Or at least the most adaptable, hopefully.
I don't know what that was.
Some kind of weird little guitar riff?
Yeah, but that was the fucking the Doom guitar riff, but I don't know what that did aside from fucking be cool.
Probably alerting. Okay. Check the map. It
doesn't tell me what it does. That only tells me Doom drones, secrets, elite guards, Argent cells, rune trials. Yeah, so that doesn't really. Whatever.
Okay, that's good.
Sure, it is something neat and interesting that we will find out about at some point. But I'm glad that I stopped to find it. Because whether it does nothing, I fucking love that music.
Yeah, that's vaguely the Doom theme. Yeah, there you go.
Healing power.
So, when you have a power up, you get healed.
Yeah.
It's not a bad deal.
It's not terrible. I think I'll hold out for the, all the secrets get displayed immediately on my map. The trick is to relax your throat and it just keeps going.
Yeah. Go back.
No, I know that the way I'm supposed to go. That's the point of the video game, is that if the game wants you to go there, that's clearly the right way to go. If the game is kind of ignoring it, then that's where all the fun secrets are.
Good point.
So if I'm going somewhere where I'm not supposed to be yet. I completely lost place where I am.
Olivia has an artifact in her private lab that we've been studying for years. I believe you can use it to find the answers you seek. It bears your mark.
He's already told me that.
Olivia's personal laboratory is not part of the registered facilities database. Alpha level clearance will be required to locate it. Granted.
You can access her Lazarus facility from the north sector of the Advanced Research Complex. About 80 kilometers
Soma,
away.
Right?
Yeah. You told me to get it.
I'll bring the transmitter online to take you there. But you'll need a UAC corporate facilities clearance card
good.
To activate
it. Didn't beat it.
There
one
is a security
time.
Station nearby.
I found that the best way to get through playing games is to start one, finish one. And then if you really, really want to play that next one, it'll give you even more of a reason to be going to the play.
Yeah. Sales make that challenging.
I believe it.
Isn't it so much easier to just keep punching?
Yeah. It's kind of hard to see what I'm doing, but it's a lot more effective. There it goes. It wasn't there. I'm pretty sure I must have unlocked that damn thing by now. Yeah, there we go. There we go. So I've now increased the distance that I can commit murder from.
There you go.
Test this sucker out.
Oh, baby! Love it! It's longer.
Dude, look at that. You're doing a shadow step. Truly.
Careful, careful.
Got it.
Oh, double whammy. Lovely. Immediately appeared behind it. Yeah, that works.
That'll do it. That'll do the
day. All day.
Yes, it does some sort of shockwave thing.
Well, yes. I would assume. So, everyone's freaking out. I was just giving a mass effect, but for some reason, maybe like a rock star instead. Everyone's freaking out about this. Red Dead 2 potential. And I am waiting to see
what comes out.
If they're actually gonna do it, because for all I know, they're gonna do something else.
Yeah. I mean, I wouldn't put it past them.
Except the last three big conferences of the industry, people have been expecting them to announce it, and they haven't.
And they've also been expecting the NX, but look how that went.
Yeah, Nintendo's different from Rockstar.
Okay.
Yes, I guess in some other ways, but also in many other ways.
That was a... But, yes, I believe that the Rockstar folk... Whatever. They make, like, one game every...
generation. Or two, actually. People lucked out last gen, because they got three out of them. Right, technically four.
All of their games are of a very consistent and high quality, which is something to be admonished.
Actually, they made four games last gen.
Did they?
GTA 4, yeah. L.A. Noire, Red Dead Redemption, and GTA.
L.A. Noire was not last year.
I said last generation.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know if GTA 5 you would count as working with last generation.
It started out in last generation.
Oh, that's right. I forgot there was like a year until they were on the next gen, and then there was another year before it was on PC. Wow. Still really that? Dropped the ball with that one.
What are you talking about? They did that on purpose.
To make people buy it on the console before they play it on PC?
Well, there's a bit of that, but they've also reported saying, that it gave them more time to improve the next...
the performance?
Yeah, on modern and then...
Sure.
PC platform.
Yeah.
Right, that's it. PC store.
I don't think there's any haters, necessarily.
That's a joke. There would fuck the same way. It's not practical advice, it's the best advice you'll ever get.
Isn't it delightful to have too many weapons to choose from?
It is when they're all of a certain level of quality.
Okay, yeah, I got you. Yeah, because about a third of these weapons are kind of expendable.
Well, I'm sure they have their purpose. I haven't quite figured out what half of them are. I'm rapidly running out of ammunition for all of them. I don't know if I've got the use of the chance out of fucking killing anything.
There you go.
There we go. That's one. Oh, right. Do that.
Wow! You just got punched to many bits.
My love.
Desserts!
Truck burger! How would you like making fun?
Uh-oh, dude.
Yeah. That was the other weird thing about this. Oh, there we go. The demo for Doom at E3 kind of fucked up. So
for this Doom?
Yeah. The dude was running through a playtest build, and...
He's talking about this year's E3?
Rather, the last one. There were supposed to be different animations for the chainsaw load up,
yeah.
But they didn't. So he cut through three enemies with the exact same chainsaw animation each time,
yeah.
And people's initial reaction to that were,
Remember when we were at PAX East and this game had about, a tenth of the show floor dedicated to it, and we didn't play it?
Well, because I'm not going to wait in line for shit I'm going to play later.
Yeah.
Like, unless it's something...
It was so close to release, too, that...
Right, that it didn't particularly feel worth it. But later on, I'm very glad I went and got to chat up the, whatchamacallit, guys? Fury booth.
Oh, easily.
Yeah, and okay, so here we go. Kill four or more demons during a single mobile turret. Deploy five times. That is very poorly worded, but I get what they're getting at.
What are they getting at? I wasn't paying attention.
Exactly. I need to deploy the mobile turret five times and kill at least four people every time I do. which is doable.
So how many weapons left we got on the docket coming up from the missions here?
How many weapons are left, or how many levels are left?
How many weapons? There's 13 levels.
I think we cleared them out.
Really?
That's about it. And I'm pretty sure...
Obviously the last one's going to be the BFG.
Right, but I think that might be like a end boss proprietary.
Yeah.
Unless I check, this thing is pretty much as overpowered as you can get.
Wow. Yeah. Well, good one.
Yeah, that was my fault.
I mean...
So...
I can't...
it mean kill four enemies in a single burst?
Read it again. Loading times. How do people put up with the loading times on Dark Souls?
They get a PC.
Yeah. I guess.
Or swap out the hard drive to a solid state.
But what percent of the people... Obviously, there's a lot of core gamers that play Dark Souls, so right. They may have either of those instances. But a lot of the people that I knew who played played Dark Souls in any iteration were just playing it regular and just waited for it to load every single time.
Yeah.
And I would look at them wait and like, what are you doing?
Yeah, it's pretty vague about it. But the fucking whatever. The people who don't care to improve their console or improve their gameplay, whatever, just kind of go with what they got.
I guess so. They just kind of aren't invested in wondering what could possibly be with their game performance.
Provides a significant increase in control and in-air movement after a double jump. Collect 15 health rails and reach the ultimate sprint record.
It's a race mode. Okay, fair enough.
I
can dig it.
Fuck it. People... Whatever. I find this load time to be rather long compared to what I'm doing on the PC.
It is long.
And I've got...
This is a long load time.
6-year-old Raptor drives. Which are probably ancient by now. Right. So, it depends on the hardware. I guarantee you the PlayStation 4 Pro is gonna have...
Yes. But not for the...
What?
Unless there's going to be a solid trade-in value from a regular PlayStation 4 to the PlayStation 4 Pro.
It probably is.
But it would have to be you only paid the difference of the $100, which will not be the case, I guarantee you.
I'd say maybe half.
Even still, for that kind of...
What was the price point?
$399. Right now, what I have, ignore the fact that I have the Destiny Edition. If it was a regular PlayStation 4, it's $299 with a game, whether it's the regular base one or the slim model. So, it's a...
Fuck.
So, technically, if you don't count the game, the $60 game bundled in, the software, the console is now a value of... What, $140?
Something like that.
No, I'm sorry, $240.
I think the point that we're looking to get at is you want to not have to spend that much in trading in.
Right. So, like, how different is the performance going to be to spend that extra amount on the console that I have? When for the price, if I really did want a 4K machine, I could have the X-Bone, the new X-Bone.
You could buy a PC.
But I'm saying the price of the PC is a completely different number.
know what I mean?
I don't know, man. Check. Are there any good deals for a PS4 trade-in?
I don't know of any. Considering that I
kind of looked at it.
Oh, find out.
I just love now how console players are pretending to care about what a teraflop is and does.
Oh. I love that PC is at HDR for like 10 years and nobody cared. Now all of a sudden everybody cares. PC players go, yeah, and?
Well, people care now because there are TVs that can be in your living room with HDR content.
Instead of monitors that have had it pretty much since Boca. Okay. Boca.
Okay.
B-O-K-E-A-H or whatever.
Boca.
Bookie. Sure. Bookie. It's some camera thing. Well, so is HDR, so who cares? Whatever. People are sheep.
Yeah. Easily.
Buy Apple.
People are cheap. Buy Apple?
No, I said people are sheep. Buy Apple.
Oh. Because either one of those statements makes sense, the other is completely contradictory.
That's the one I want.
This is what we do.
It allows me to they stay stunned.
Those who came before
that
and those with whom you serve all operate with the same goal in mind. The development of a new dog.
Doubled up, it creates a rather undefeatable combo. A wombo combo, if you will.
Those who came before you and those with whom you serve all operate with the same goal in mind.
You have
the development of a new dawn for mankind. It is by
this
time.
This is new. I think it dropped you off as you go to the area before.
Something like that.
It's adorable! Kill it!
No, not with that.
There's two of them!
Yep, as I thought. It takes like a quarter damage from the front. That's the one. Oh, I ripped this butthole of them. That's different. What's this one called?
Oh,
a pinky.
Oh, that is a pinky.
Yeah.
Kill it with fire! I guess that's kind of redundant in the context of this game.
Well, considering everything is fire-based.
Because you know, it's all in hell! Wow, that's a good upgrade. Didn't nail it.
Charge. Argent facility.
Well, hey, two extra friends who are watching. Thanks for watching.
Do I know who they are?
Nah.
Well, let's ask them.
They can if they want to, but...
Who are you, nerds, and why are you here?
I don't know. It's YouTube. It's a whole different...
Right, well, there's a chat.
Yes, I know there's a chat.
Good. So, if you're listening to us being...
Those who came before
ridiculous,
and those
you could be Dylan at work, because he's not doing anything.
Hello, Dylan at work, who's not doing anything. Your brother finds your time highly valuable.
I do find his time valuable.
Good. He's a good kid.
Alan Johnson. Hey, Alan Johnson. What's up?
Not your brother.
No. Nope. Well, there's another individual who was watching.
Named Alan Johnson. Also, not your brother.
It's possible that neither of them are my brother.
That is correct.
Because let's be honest, he's at a beach hotel
gets terrible internet. So
where?
And it works the front desk at a future hotel.
Ah.
No, he's here.
Oh. Trying to figure out what this thing does.
What's that?
Your ghost cannon?
Yes, the one that I call the railgun, but isn't actually a railgun.
Correct. And then it is a pinky bubble destroyer.
Ah! Good. That should be the description. We should just go and redo all the descriptions for these weapons.
That does seem to be its general purpose in life. Oh,
that guy didn't
have a good day. About that.
Forgot about what?
Shazbot.
Shazbot?
I forgot about Gray.
That demon seems to have taken your keycard. You will need to find it.
Yeah, that happens.
It will not be accessible without proper clearance.
That's what happened. You forgot about Gray.
Why don't they have that for guns more often?
What?
The reload.
It's not Metroid, you gotta... Yeah.
Alright. There is one for guns. Just don't get them very often.
Yes. Pretty sure I...
Oh, that's fun. SpongeBob! Pinky! Yeah, it works. Ooh!
So goddamn.
Aw,
they do a little
kami-kami-kami. Oh, everybody's watching the debate. There's a debate.
I can debate.
Yeah? What can you say that's nice about Donald Trump?
Well, his kids aren't shit.
Wow, you're just ripping off Hillary Clinton's comment.
Ripping off, I do believe you mean mocking.
That too.
Yeah.
You're one of those.
Right, in that case. What's the nicest thing about... God damn it. Kill a revenant while it is in midair. Kill 5 demons with a chainsaw. Acquire 3 data blocks.
Which one's the revenant? Is it the lanky one?
It is the... Not that one. Revenant.
Yeah, it is the lanky one.
That should be easy enough. Fuck, what was I doing? God damn it.
Killing.
Oh, shit. Perform 25 death on the level. Oh, I'm crouching.
Ah!
I know exactly why I'm crouching. What the hell is going on?
Leopard has ruined you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can see that.
I'm expecting so goddamn much.
I never really got the height.
What?
Yeah.
Play it with other people?
It is.
There's the hype.
Yeah. Still didn't get it.
Yeah, boy.
You know, I think it's just like I have limited interest in the zombie genre.
It's not even so much about the zombies. Zombies are just a means to an end.
Yeah. I mean, the gameplay's fine.
That's why we're there. Team-based is particularly...
Maybe I just didn't like the way that the people I was playing with were playing.
So Field?
Was I playing with Field?
No, it's the only game we played for years.
Yeah,
maybe. Huh. I'm glad that worked out. Because I had no idea what that would do. Damn it! I keep forgetting about this shit.
With the chain gun?
Yes, yeah, so I'm supposed to kill 4 of these bastards. Somebody's messing with me.
Union Aerospace was founded by Trump. There you go, that's one positive thing that's not mocking Hillary Clinton. And we will end it there.
torso. Union Aerospace.
Pretty much.
Oh yeah, I forgot I got that to work on here.
What'd you get?
I have decided. Let me review. And it's going to take forever, but whatever. I am going to try to... That was there the entire time.
Yeah, there you go. That'll make it easier. I'm surprised you missed it. It was right in the middle.
Yep. My preferred method of the periphery did not save me that time.
Your eyeballs.
And also that. I've decided to go through all of the Mega Man Battle Network games again, because I am an insane fucking monster.
No kidding.
Yeah. Because there is a metric fuck ton of those.
Yeah.
There we go. So now...
I feel like there's... Aren't there more of those than there are core Mega Man games?
I mean, it depends on what you define core, but yes, there is
a... As in... Well, I guess X is different from Mega Man 1 through 8 and 9.
Well, no. X is... core in some ways. Because they are a mainline game. They're just kind of a spin-off that got its own spin-off that became in some cases more popular than the... Oh, I can cheat on these little bastards. Alright. I'm liking the sound of that. Fuck, really?
Whoa.
Didn't die immediately.
Yeah, you should have just punched him.
Well, I want to bump up the damn... God damn it, Evan. I want to improve my gun. Yep, see, that counted as one. Okay.
There you go.
So I'm just gonna cheat the little bastards. And one of the big bastards is going to spawn.
Employee discount, it's the Gamers Club Unlocked. It's 20% off all new inbox games, no matter how old they are. So you get it $12 off. Okay. Go get that power up!
Whatever that was.
Yeah, that's I hate McConaughey.
What? Why?
He's an ass.
Who isn't?
He accepted an Oscar, and instead of thanking anybody, he thanked himself from the future.
As you do.
Demon breach detected.
Hit the boom. Again, that guy is still the worst. I mean, yes, it's arguable, but he's pretty bad.
Manageable. But I get it. That guy gets no, but never has to check. I did get it! Where'd that floating little thing go?
I don't know.
Unauthorized exploration into the exclusion zones outside the base is prohibited.
Because it went this way, right? And then up.
Yeah.
I do believe.
Yeah, that works.
Ooh.
Lucky
on that one.
There he is! You found the bastard.
So now, I'm stuck between the other upgrade for the turret and siege mode. I can't move while in siege mode.
But look at what it does!
It's the other one that's a sniper rifle attachment. Yeah, siege mode.
I love it.
Just
punch the thing.
The sucker punch is a nice touch.
It's like, thanks.
That'll work.
Don't waste it yet.
There's four? No, I'm counting these knuckleheads.
Pistol.
Alright. Dog.
There you go.
I figure.
It's stalking you up, so that would.
Oh, say, right.
Oh, yeah, you gotta do that.
Probably electrified. Okay, so then. Nope, I. Okay, I know what I'm gonna do. Because I. Intelligence.
No, don't.
So. Oh! I did not realize I could do that. So, the answer to that question is intelligence or not? Not that siege mode, though.
Yeah, that'll do.
Still haven't tried out the siege mode, though. Nothing, you gotta... Oh, God. You gotta sit the sucker down and aim it good. Is that all? Oh.
That works.
That'll do.
Pretty fast. Surprisingly.
And lovingly effective. Yeah. again, music's still going, so like something is still alive.
There he is.
Speak of the devil.
Is that a pawn?
I don't know if it worked.
Kinda.
Kinda look fun?
No. It turned his back into
ham.
Ground beef.
And now I'm sorry.
There you go.
Alright, did I get enough from that chain gun? Good? Eh. Whatever, I'll cut something else in half. Something. Raging demon.
Thank God.
Could have been close. Gotta Riddick myself. Excellent.
Riddick it up.
Oh, that's right.
Chronicles of Ridiculous. It kind of is.
Church room now has a devastating area of effect. Please.
Booyah.
Beam charge time is reduced and allows movement while using siege mode.
Lovely place, Mars is.
That's about as good as NASA can expect. Entertaining enough where we insulted Trump too much.
We mentioned him once. That's all it takes.
That's enough.
PlayStation tracking.
PlayStation?
Yeah.
No, that's it. Did Sony do a cool thing?
I don't know. PlayStation 3 early adopters can now claim other OS settlement cash.
Oh, no shit. Right, they actually went and did that. God, that's a long ass time.
April 2010.
Yeah.
Was the limit.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me!
Did you get it?
No.
Oh.
I died at the last humanly possible second.
Alright, and then we got PlayStation Network trending.
April of 2010?
Anyone who bought a PlayStation 3 prior to April of 2010 can take some of it cash.
How much?
Find out.
Yeah, I bought one.
Technically, the PlayStation 3 that I have was bought on launch day, but I didn't buy it.
Well.
But I didn't buy it. It was a kid that I am not connected to anymore.
Depending on how much we get from it, it might be worth getting in touch with. I'm not going to you that much, that's bitter.
Up to $55.
Ooh, there you go.
Oh, wait. All consumers who purchased an original model Fat PlayStation 3 console before April 2010 are eligible to receive a $9 payment by filling out an online claim form.
Come on.
Users who can provide proof of installing an alternative operating system on the PlayStation 3 prior to the loss of other OS compatibility may receive settlement payments as high as $55. So everybody else, it's $9. If you try to install the other operating system, it's $55 maybe. Class members who submit a claim with a required proof of purchase and proof of use of the other OS feature are entitled to receive $55. Class members who submit a claim with
proof that you
You got to fill out a survey form, probably a serial number. Deadline for claims, objections, and exclusions for the PlayStation 3's other S settlement is December 7th. Cash settlements will be released following a final approval hearing, which is dated January 24th, 2017.
Cool. So what did I get? Glory Killing Demons drops armor. Well, that's perfect for number 3.
PlayStation Network goes down as Call of Duty and PlayStation VR become available. And yet our stream is working.
Grandfather did.
I don't think so. I've only been a PlayStation Plus subscriber since last September.
I've been on and off, yeah. Should have thought this through more. They spawned behind me, but I don't care because I've got bullets. Actually, again, if I was smart. Shoot. Oh, is that max ammo? I gotta get more of them,
Argent energies.
Sure.
Yeah, I kind of dumped it all into health.
Well,
may as well try to
better off in the long run, but
yeah.
Fuck armor, so the next thing we're doing is all ammo.
Yep. It's fuck armor.
Well, it's not explicitly as in four.
Well, there's less drops. It's the least amount of drop.
You are correct. Oh, I just realized I only have one eye. That's fine.
Who only has one eye?
The little demonoids. Yeah. Kill a revenant while it's still in midair. I haven't done that yet. I feel like I've done that.
Yeah, I think you did too.
Never.
Scratch that up. What chapter are we on? We gotta be on like 10 by now, right?
We can probably finish it tonight.
Depending on what's going on.
Does it say?
I was just curious.
Don't text me, not.
I'm assuming this is the end of the mission since there's a ship right here that you're probably going to be using.
It does look pretty relevant.
It's also kind of a closed off arena for the most part.
Murder all of the extraneous stuff. Murder this thing properly.
What's that yellow?
I have no idea. There. That's
you got it. You got the thing.
Now I can get this. Oh,
that's
faster.
Yeah. That works. Thorough shopper, huh?
Still don't know what happened.
Well, thorough shopper is probably from the upgrade that you just got.
Whoa. Okay. Damn it!
God! Fuck!
Still not as cool as the diamond lava.
Do you still get that upgrade?
I don't know.
Let's try it.
I mean, I assume so if I get to keep all of my other stuff through death.
Death.
Yeah, probably.
Boca.
Pop the boca. Boca the grande. I'm assuming you're satisfied with your cheese dust.
Oh, you don't like my cheese dust?
Not on my futon.
Oh. I'll clean it.
I'm gonna back tomorrow anyway.
No.
Shit.
I'll just lick it clean.
No, don't lick my couch. It's gross.
Gross. So what else is new in the news?
Ah! It seems like most of it is just fucking game PlayStation game. Fucking people over.
Game the viewer.
Yes, we did. Oh, hello, third viewer. How art thou? It's my goal to make this awkward.
It is.
And they're gone.
So, you succeeded.
Yeah.
Did I get it?
Fun times.
Did I get it?
I don't know.
Did I get it? Yeah, I got it. Okay, so now. Oh. Back.
Specialist. Yeah. Yeah, checkpoints tend to do that, Mr. Allen.
Wait, what did it do?
He said that it made you start all the way back there, but... The kid was talking about the aerospace.
The mobile turret mode will no longer stall. Okay. So it'll still overheat, it just won't do anything.
Popular article. Fans go crazy for Red Dead Redemption 2 teaser coming straight from Rockstar Games. It's literally their logo in red and black that's slightly faded.
Oh, is that what that was?
Yes. Well, that's what people are assuming it was. But it could just as easily be...
Okay, I knew I was famous.
Anything. And don't get me wrong, I would love another Red Dead. I would love a remaster of Red Dead Redemption.
I'd love that they would actually follow up on their PC port that they promised.
Great. You know they're gonna they'll do a remaster for these consoles with a PC version.
I'm 100% sure that that's necessary. And Red Dead Redemption, like a lot of Rockstar games,
looks great.
Okay, I guess that's where we're going with that.
What? No, go ahead.
I was gonna say, it's a lot more structurally beautiful than it is. Get another comment. It's a lot more structurally beautiful than it is. Graphically beautiful. It's a lot more interesting that they managed to cram so much stuff into one spot more than it's pretty to look at, you know?
Yeah.
That's how it's always been. The
well, it, you know, it just felt like for that generation, there weren't too many games that were able to follow through for a whole game on this feels like a living, breathing world. And I haven't played it in a while, but it was able to do that pretty consistently through the game. And the openness of it felt appropriate as a Western.
Yeah.
You know, like all the sparse placement of the content actually made sense.
Well, yeah, because it's the death of the West.
Mm-hmm.
The comment was him making a note on he forgot to set checkpoints because Doom 3 did quick saves.
Oh yeah, you're right. Oh, thank God this thing has quick save, or this thing has checkpoint.
Yeah.
That quick save business is effective, but you gotta remember to do it.
Yeah.
The way I played Doom 3, I think I hotkeyed it to a, like a auxiliary button on my mouse, so that I was basically clicking it every time I hit shoot. Dude, I'm not sure if you remember Doom 3, but
I don't
think we remember Doom 3.
I think I demoed it on Xbox once.
Really?
The original Xbox.
Well,
yeah.
There's the Doom 3...
And by that, I mean, like, at Game Crazy, when it was still around.
Nah. The BFG mode is out. Or BFG... Whatever.
The big BFG edition.
Yeah.
Yeah, which came with Doom 1 and Doom 2 on the disc. We have that at Best Buy.
For the PS4?
PS3 and 360.
That would be why.
Yeah.
It's basically where all the cool games went. Well, it's still on PC, so really gotta switch it over. Because I'm telling you, man, and the same thing I've explained to Graham is that it's not the difference that you'd be expecting. It's the difference between...
Your car needs to be moved.
What?
Your car needs to be moved.
Okay.
Yeah, so that's getting to be picked up from work.
Okay.
So we'll just we'll end the stream here.
You sure? We're close to the end.
Well, we don't need to stream through the end. Well, anyway, Mr. Allen, thanks for watching. Check out the website. We're going to be streaming more. I don't know.